All right, is this working here? Can you guys see this? Let me see. All right, cool. So, I don't know if you can see this little keyboard setup over here. Let me make that bigger. You might be wondering what the hell is going on. This weird keyboard. It's just some old gear I had, but yeah, I wanted to see if it would work with heavy paint, and guess what? We got it. It's working. And we can do this. So what does that mean? We can go like let's see, let's pick rake. Sorry. Yeah, let's get draw just for now and check it out. We can change the colors on the fly. Woo! Got manual color jitter now. So yeah, I don't know how useful this will be for actual painting, but we'll see. I'm gonna try to use it today. Alright, let's see. What else we have? This actually works nicely with the texture brushes, because you can control the size on the fly. Which, I know you can do this in most programs, but with pen pressure, but we don't have pen pressure yet. So what we got is MIDI pressure. let's see. That. So anyway, I'm excited about this. My friend Kirk is working on this power glove version with MIDI sliders, and we're gonna try to hook it up to heavy paint later and see if we can get some slider action. Hey Destiny Bub. We're just demoing some color jitter here. Or actually, not color jitter, some slider stuff. And then also, like, you can hook up buttons on the pads to different tools. You know, like here's rectangle. This is rake. And then this is draw. It looks super dark. What looks super dark? You guys see? I hope. Alright, anyway, let's go. Yeah, it's because I'm in a closet. There's a window here. I should probably just open that, but I can't see shit now. I like the little light up shit on these little keyboards. Okay. So let's get into it here. Let's see if this will be actually useful at all. I think you can be more sensitive with this. Maybe. More red. Whoa, you can do fades right here, guys. Check that out. Huh. Try that again. Interesting. No, I do not play piano. I don't know why I have this thing. It's kind of a waste. But not anymore. Oh, yeah. There we go. Oops. All right, let's get Rake in here. Could you guys see this being useful or not really? I'm not sure about it. We just kind of figured this out yesterday, so trying to figure out how a painter would actually use these knobs. Oops. I would say, actually, ooh, I'm having a sinking feeling that clicking on the bars is actually faster than turning these knobs and maybe more accurate. I can't see anything because of the glare. I'm gonna close that up. Oh, Cintiqs have this knob too? Or they have some kind of a knob? I don't use a Cintiq, so I don't know anything about how they work. Okay, now I can actually see what the hell's going on my screen. It's too much glare. Can you follow my Blender tutorials without custom shortcuts? You can if you already know all the commands, like all the equivalent commands, but I think that kind of defeats the whole purpose of a tutorial. So I would say no. It's going to be very difficult unless you already know what you're doing, in which case you wouldn't be watching a tutorial. Weekend was good. We went painting at IKEA with the Weekend Warrior group here in LA. I've used the same MIDI keyboard at one point in Photoshop. I felt it was a hassle to get it into muscle memory, but it was a fun experiment. How did you do like Photoshop? What did you use it for? For like hotkeys and stuff or for colors or yep, that's the one. The giant IKEA in Burbank. Yeah, like I said, you should come out to the painting group on the weekends, because there's a lot of gouache painters and digital painters and stuff. Yeah, a lot of people came. It was like, I don't know, maybe 15 people or so. Hey, Didi. Check this out, Didi. I think you might appreciate this. We got MIDI control on Heavy Paint now. These sliders. And also, you can choose different tools here with the. Woo! I don't know how useful it is, but I'm trying. Trying it out. I'm testing. Try airbrush. So far, my initial reaction is not that useful. It's cool to look at, but not that useful. But who knows? The one thing that you can do here that you can't do with a regular is you can change colors while you're painting. But I figure it might be. I'm gonna try to get this working with multi-touch on mobile devices next, so we can have it. So we can do this with multi-touch on a phone. Won't be able to do it on a desktop, but it's okay. I think most people are using their phones for this stuff anyway. Yeah, we do need EDM here to match. It's slowly turning into a DJ channel. Well, anyway, I like this picture because it's very simple. There's only a couple shapes in here, so should be able to wrap this one quickly, I hope. But, you know, that's my famous last words every single day. So, don't be fooled. Oh fuck. It just crashed. One second. It's probably 'cause I'm changing the modes with these pad keys and not really paying attention, but let me double check that and make sure. So we do have replay, autosave, so crashes don't really matter as much anymore. See? Kept everything. Let's see. So what was I doing? I had a fill. And I switched to line. Ooh. Crash. Switching from fill to line. Okay, that's a pretty big one. Oh, I know why. I changed the name of my size slider. One second, guys. Dot size. Dot value. Let me go and find all of these instances. Only this one. just make sure that I didn't forget size anywhere else. I'm just looking through all the code and trying to see if I misnamed this size slider anywhere. Sorry about this, but I want to do it before I forget. Size. So the new name is n.size. The old name was like n. or canvas.size slider or something. n.canvas.size. This one here. Okay, this is old. Let me change that. Oh wait, that did get changed. Okay, good. n.size. Okay, I think that's it. That should be done. All right, let's reopen that. That bug shouldn't be in any of the releases because I just changed that like yesterday and didn't realize it. Okay. Also, I'm adding back in a little bit of hotkeys, so spacebar is control and spacebar are eyedropper now. So you can just hold down spacebar on your keyboard and get your eyedropper. I guess that's useful. Let me recrop that. It's gonna be in the next update. It's not in the current one right now. See, I'm already ditching the MIDI. But I am still excited to try it with the glove version. So you're just like holding it on your... I think that might be more useful than this version right here. Good old-fashioned California sunset. I'm gonna try using circle tool to make these the ring here. Might be easier. It's hard to snap it right in the middle there. Ah. Okay. Okay, and then some teal. I'm gonna give a overall red glow everywhere behind this. Hopefully that'll help these white things pop off a little bit more. Oops. Same thing with these neons. I'll just add in a glow there, and then put in the really hot neons afterwards in the middle. Something like that. Blah, blah, blah. Blah blah blah, and then blah 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 blah. Yeah, thanks. This is my painting hat. All right. Oh, now I can see the emojis in the chat way better. Cool. Except for sour, please. I don't know how. I need to activate that one, whatever that is. Let's pick that color. Oops, wrong one. Whoa. All right, let's get, whoa. BTTV. Let me write this down, because you tell me this like every time and I keep forgetting the name of what the hell I'm supposed to do. Let me write it down. BTTV. Emotes. Yeah, so I mean, all these signs are basically just this little silly two-step process. First, you put in a fill or like a soft glow with a darker value, and then you go back in with a much, much higher, like hotter color, and then you put that on. Which this painting is like 90% just that, so it should be over relatively quick compared to some of our other paintings, I hope. Brighter and hotter. There's the right. Oh, sorry about that. Is this better? Whoa, what is that? Emoji. Crazy. Greener version. Yeah, I don't know. Do you guys take pictures of stuff to paint? 'Cause I just started. I feel like I've started doing that a lot more lately now that I know that I gotta constantly be on the lookout for stuff to paint with you guys. But I'm enjoying it though. I feel like now I have a little, it's like a little side quest. I'm always on the I'm looking out for stuff all the time. It's kind of fun. Oop. This goes here. Oh, nice. Yeah, it's fun to like guess what will be a good painting. And then sometimes the real like uninteresting photo can be a cool painting somehow. Or the other thing too is like, lately I've been trying to edit my paintings a lot before, or edit the photos before painting, which I never used to do. I would just go off the straight color, but I feel like the editing step is really important, and I don't know why I never did that before, but I think a lot of artists do that. And you can, fine-tune the colors and get more contrast or more saturation. I feel like saturation's the main thing I usually end up messing with. It's tough getting a photo that really felt like what you're seeing. Yeah. True. Although, do you mess with your like photo settings, the color and the light and every exposure and everything afterwards? Because I feel like
Imaginez la forme de la boîte
you can
crânienne,
get so much more out of your photos
son épaisseur,
if you mess
sa
around
durée. Comparez le plan mental à une
with
scène
the
de
settings
théâtre sur
afterwards.
laquelle évoluent des
Because
personnages.
this photo, for example,
Ce sont les
looked kind of
images,
lame
les
before I
pensées, les pensées,
just
les pensées.
bumped up the
Ordonnez à
saturation
ces
and
acteurs de se
everything.
retirer et conservez une seule image. Installez-vous dans cette pensée.
I can show you
De ce
guys
moment,
what it looks like.
vous cessez de faire
Let me
et
see.
commencez à être.
My photos. I'll show you how I usually do this. Yeah, so like going from something like that to something like that. Or yeah, this photo that we're working on right now. Let's see the original for a second. Click and hold to compare it. Yeah, here's the original. Kind of dull. Looks very boring, but with some extra color, I think it looks more fun. But yeah, I've been doing that for all these photos. Taken gazillions of pictures lately. This one have edits on it? Oh yeah, here's the original. And with some edits. Yeah. Makes for a better painting, I think. Lot of photos. I kind of like this garage here. Oh, this photo is so crappy though. Anyway, let's get back to it.
Laissez se faire le flux et le reflux. C'est alors qu'émerge l'essentiel, ce que l'on est.
Yeah, it is unrealistic. It's like a comic book version of reality, but
vous êtes tranquillité.
There's still reflections going on with these cars, but it's just so dark overall. It's like almost invisible, which is really straining to try to look at these colors and pick them out. But I guess that's what makes this piece cool, I guess. It's friggin' dark. Friggin' dark. Frig. Whenever I hear the word frig, I think of Randy from Trailer Park Boys. I think Randy owns the word frig now. Needs more frig. Kind of canceling out that bright gradient with a dark gradient, making it all confusing. Nobody knows what's going on. Thanks for the follow, Margarino. Okay. Are you painting today, Margarino? Or just spectating? I think we have a lot of spectators in here, but not that many painters. Lights should be more orange, I think, towards the end. And in the middle it can get hot. Welcome, Benthomasaurus. Welcome. I hope you are. Hope you're joining in to paint. Hello. Yeah, for any of you guys who are new, we're doing these pretty much daily. I'm just trying to keep a routine going and get better at painting digitally. Music instead of streamer music. So all this stuff is just one time only, live today and gone tomorrow. But at least we get to listen to some decent music. Bob's Big Boy in Burbank, California, which is a 24-hour diner. It's been around for a while, I guess, and they have car shows and stuff here. Oh, okay. And Didi's are streaming expert. We'd be lost without him. Oops. Were you using Twitch when it was Justin TV? Oh yeah, we should give Didi a follow. Didi does programming stuff. Art too, I guess. Although it seems like he's always too busy to paint. Yeah, I listened to a podcast about the origin of Twitch, and it sounded crazy. Like, they started with a... It was just a stream of this guy, Justin, doing his daily... Like, it was just a stream of Justin all day long, 24/7. That's all it was. It was Justin TV. The first stream. And then he got, like, really sick and just... had all sorts of like psychological issues from streaming too much or something, or I don't know, like he had a camera strapped to his head or something. I don't know, I might be remembering this all wrong, but that, I think that's what the podcast was saying. And poor Justin, I feel so bad for Justin. Imagine having your life like that's just Truman Show but for real. And didn't they ever see that movie and see what happens? If you're being watched all the time, you go crazy. Totally inspired the Truman Show. Yeah. Maybe they watched the Truman Show and then they're like, yeah, let's do that. That looks fun. But I guess it was a good idea. Just to show you, stupid ideas can really be great. There's no such thing as a stupid idea. In the startup world, there's no such thing as a stupid idea, I guess. If you guys could have a startup company, what would your stupid idea be? What would your stupid app do? If I had a startup, I feel like I would. It would be. I've always wanted to make a foot-operated faucet, so you don't have to turn on and off the faucet every time you're washing dishes and stuff. But that's not really an app, so never mind. I don't know if you guys have stupid app ideas. Or smart app ideas, I don't know. Did I have this glare over here? It's kind of a photographic error, but maybe it's cool. My dumb idea was a bowl separating cereal and milk, but found it's already there. Doing well. Damn, okay, so you got potential. You got potential. You got the good ideas. You need the execution. You need the execution. That's cool. I didn't know that existed. Are they like making millions off of that? Didi says, I'd love to have dumb ideas. What are you saying, man? Like, you have no dumb ideas? Are you saying you're too smart for us? Are you saying that you're too cool for school? He's like, what would that be like to have a dumb idea? What would that? That's amazing. Dang. Dumb ideas are fun, though. You should try it sometime. I think I made this blue too dark. So dumb that I can't even have a dumb idea. Then are you just saying that you don't have ideas, period? Oh man. Come on, you guys in everybody in the chat, I know you got some stupid business idea that you've thought that somebody else stole, or maybe nobody's stolen it yet, and you just don't know if you have the effort or will power to bring this idea to life. What are your dumb business ideas? That shadow is like really hard to see there. Dang, guys. Okay, that's your homework for next time. You gotta think of at least one stupid business idea. You never, like, it doesn't even have to be a business idea. It could just be something where something in your life where you think, oh, that's really annoying, and there's probably a better way to do that. Or you have, you know, just an improvement on something, on some problem. Okay, Didi says, I love to make bread and pizza, so I'd like to have a bakery, but inside have a room for Wi-Fi, co-work, game, art, and jam place. Oh man, a bread cafe. A bake and game cafe. A bread-fi cafe? A loaf lounge. Wee loaf. We could call it Wee Loaf. I like that. Oh, I would love to go to a bread cafe. Just eat loaves and code. Loaf and code. That totally sounds like a startup name. Loaf and Code. Dude, come on. Loafin. Yeah. Lo-fi. Oh my god. Makery Bakery. Loaf Coffee and Code. I loaf to code. Oh man. Come on. These ideas are just writing themselves. Yeah, man. You got this. Loafing code. Although my friend, my old neighbor, he and his mom started, they actually tried to start a internet cafe business one time. This was like 2005 or so, and it was right before the recession, so the business kind of failed. But it was really exciting though. They bought a bunch of computers and they had all these LEDs and stuff and they got loans and stuff, but yeah, unfortunately it didn't turn out. It was also about the time when all those internet cafes were sort of going out of style in Miami, but it was exciting though. Definitely physical business seems a lot more difficult than a startup, like a digital a software business. Physical b retail business seems really scary, 'cause then you gotta invest all this money and build shit and codes and inspections and yeah, man. What about you, Colby Cheese? What's your business idea? It doesn't have to be art related, it could just be anything. What other ideas do I have? I have my main one is just the foot water faucet. I've always wanted that in a house. What else? I can't believe those there's so many businesses out there that I really don't understand how they can exist and survive. Like, especially the wine and paint business trend. Do you guys have those where you live, where it's just a little storefront that you go in and they show you how to paint a picture, and you drink wine, but then they charge you a lot of money to do that. And those businesses are everywhere. They keep popping up. It's really weird. Doesn't make any sense. Yeah, right? It's like, what? That does not compute. How is that a business? Or there's also the pottery ones where it's just like you go in and they help you make like a simple pottery thing and then charge you money for that, and people do that a lot, and that those are really popular too. It's like one of those, it's like, I guess it's like cupcakes too. I don't understand how business works. Bidet. Yeah, bidet's another thing I really want to get into. I haven't used one yet, but everybody who I know who has used one is really into them. I mean, but if you think of it, we wash our hands with a sink. So why don't we wash our ass with a sink? Like, we don't wash our hands with pieces of paper. And honestly, I think our ass needs the water a lot more than our hands do. You know, like that should definitely be an area that gets well sanitized, so you don't have an itchy butthole all day. You know what I mean? I can see the number of viewers is plummeting right now, so maybe we should move along from this subject. Just keep going. Maybe I should get back to painting. Only the strong and the few have stayed. Who here has used a bidet before? I haven't. I really want to, but I haven't. Has anybody here used a bidet? Dee Dee has used one. One time? It makes it sound so dramatic, like I did back in 79. I used a bidet once. Oh, I'll never forget that day. Bidet day. Bidet day. Bidet day. Several times in France. Those French, they have this culture. They have those French, they have this thing called culture. This crazy thing called culture. What is this? Culture. Here in Brazil, they have tiny hose. Huh. So there's different types of bidet. There's different types of bidet. I learned something new today. So some bidets are like a more like a garden spray, like a wide angle spray. And then some have like a focus laser, like a laser focus spray. Is that how it works? Okay, Cena, every day, every time he washes his ass, he has the cleanest ass out of everyone, and he has the most cleanest teeth as well because he flosses every day. Cena's styling on us with the hygiene. Cleanest ass award. My dumb idea would be a travel ass squirt gun. A travel, so like a mobile bidet. A handheld mobile bidet. That's interesting. I mean, you could probably market that, like just a regular squirt bottle, but market it as a mobile bidet, and then people like think it's more fancy and pay more money for it, I guess. It's an interesting idea. Mobile bidet. Or it's like a disposable bidet or like a trial bidet. If you're interested, but you don't want to invest in the whole system yet. You just want to try it out and see how your butthole feels about it. And then, you know what? Why don't I just do that? I should just get a little. I'll just get one of Michelle's squirt bottles that she uses to water her plants and just use that. I just hope she's not listening because she'll yell at me, but yeah, maybe I'll just do that. She's like, "Why are my plants wilting? Why are my plants turning brown? The leaves just keep falling off. I don't understand it." Why does my spray bottle smell funny? Rose gold? What's rose gold? Wait, I'm lost. I'm lost again. This area here needs some more glowage, I think. It's the fancy iPhone color. Wait, for the bidet? The portable bidet should be rose gold colored. Stream of high culture. Yeah, man, you guys got potential. Your ideas, they just need a little bit of refinement. And then you're ready to take the bidet world by storm. Yeah, what would make it different? Maybe it would be like, instead of a regular spray bottle, it could be, let me switch to a new page here. Maybe it could be like, let's see, the trigger's up here, so that part's the same. The bottle part is here, that's the same, but from here it goes down and then it goes around down into underneath the toilet, and then it goes up, and then this is the spray nozzle right here. And this is not to scale, so you'd be sitting on the toilet like this, you'd be reading your newspaper, whatever. Here's the toilet. It's a fine toilet right here. So here you're holding, let's see, you probably want to hold it this way. The trigger is going this way. You want to hold it that way. The water bottle is here. The trigger's there. And then again, let me change the color here. So that from here, we need the, this thing. So it's a like W-shaped hard plastic tube that goes right there, and then you can spray from the safety of up here. Is that how it works? How does a bidet work? You do it after you stand up, right? You're not over the toilet anymore when you do the bidet? Shoot. Or are you just standing up? Maybe you're standing up already at this point. You've completed your mission. You're standing. You hold it. For some reason, I keep wanting to put the trigger in front of us, because I feel like that's just more ergonomic. And then maybe the thing just goes around like that. So you can stand. But where do you stand in this case? Because isn't it going to just spray all over the place? I need an expert in here. Does anybody know how a bidet actually works? Do you like squat over the bidet? Do you just continue sitting on the toilet? Do you walk over to somewhere else and then do the bidet? I'm so confused. Ugh. Look, it's a ghost. It's a ghost that's doing it. Oh, jeez. Okay, is this painting over yet? Okay, Seamus McFly knows. Is coming in with some knowledge. You squat over it, and it's this whole separate apparatus from the toilet, or is it built into the toilet? Because I feel like I've seen bidets that are, it's just a bowl off to the side of the toilet, but then I've also heard of toilets that have a bidet inside them. Yeah, and thank you for speaking up, Seamus McFly. We're really having trouble getting the answers here that we need. It's separate originally, but some do have an integrated type, more like a shower. So you take a shower and then you can also poop and also bidet at the same time, all in one. All right, I'm even more confused now. Thank you for that. Let me see if this painting needs anything else. Think it's almost there. Some headlights over here too. Let's do those. Alright, DD's gotta go. I want you to take a look at some streamers. It's pixel art background stream and modeling clay stream and game dev and a digital artist, digital painter. Cool. Thanks for the recommendations. Check those out. Yeah. Dupe. Yeah, it seems like there's a lot of artists on here. A whole new world. All right, Dee Dee. See you next time. Thanks for the ideas. Let's get that bakery cafe going. That loaf cafe. All right, yeah. I think that's a good point to cut it. We got all the main stuff in here. Yeah, I'm happy with this. Okay, guys. Have a good day. See you next time. Bye-bye.